الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين، والعاقبة للمتقين. أما بعد، Number 1. Islamic History. The services Aurangzeb Alamgir rendered to the deen and its knowledge. Aurangzeb Alamgir rahimahullah had a special attachment with the knowledge of the Sharia and rendered tremendous services to the deen and deeni education, together with having many books printed. Amongst the most important books that he had printed was Rad Shi'a by Allama Hassan rahimahullah and Najmul Furqan by Maulana Muhammad Mustafa rahimahullah, which is an index of the words of the Quran. He instructed a panel of ulama from India to compile a book of Masail from all the books of fiqh, which would encompass all the aspects of fiqh. He appointed Sheikh Nizamuddin rahimahullah as head of the panel, and the result of their efforts after 8 years was Fatawa Alamgiri Shahi. A total of 20,000 rupees were spent on the project. It was the practice of Alamgir rahimahullah to have Sheikh Nizamuddin rahimahullah read him a page of the book every day, ponder over it, and then record what the consensus of the ulama was on the issue. This was an effort which really freed the ulama and student from having to refer to other books. When the Arab ulama saw the book, they were impressed and had it published under the name Fatawa Hindiya. Number 2. Allah's Pa, the Mosquito. From the factory of His power and might, Allah has created countless large and small creatures, none of which can be deemed as insignificant. If we ponder over the mosquito, we will be stunned at the creative might of Allah. Sitting on the skin of a person, it inserts its snout right through the skin, even though it appears to be a pipe, and then sucks up as much blood as it pleases. This is yet another sign of the immense power of Allah. Number 3. Afarud. Performing Salah standing up. Allah says in the Quran, "Stand humbly, obediently and silently before Allah." Surah Baqarah, verse 238. If a person has the ability to stand and perform salah, it will be farz obligatory for him to stand and perform his farz and wajib salahs. Number 4. A sunnah. Engaging in abundant zikr. Hazrat Abdullah bin Awf radiyallahu anhu reports that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Engage in zikr abundantly, avoid futile talk, prolong your salah, deliver short discourses, and never feel embarrassed in tending to the needs of widows and the poor." Nasa'i 1415. Number 5. An important act and its virtue. The treasures of Jannah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that the words "La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah" should be recited often because they are from amongst the treasures of Jannah. Tirmizi 3601 from Hazrat Abu Huraira radiyallahu anhu. Number 6. A sin. Fornication and cheating and weight and measure. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that when fornication becomes common amongst a nation, plagues will afflict them, as well as diseases that their forefathers would never had heard of. As for those who cheat in weight and measure, they will suffer droughts, grief and oppression from their rulers. Ibn Majah, 4019, from Hazrat Abdullah bin Umar radiyallahu anhu. Number 7. This world. What Allah says to His servants. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam informed us that Allah says, "O son of Adam, free yourself for worshipping me, and I shall free your hearts from the worries of this world and shut the doors of poverty from you. Otherwise, I shall keep you ever occupied and never shut the doors of poverty to you." Tirmizi 2466 from Hazrat Abu Huraira radiyallahu anhu. Number 8. The Akhirah. The clothing of the people of Jannah. Allah says in the Quran, "For these people who have iman and who do good shall be eternal Jannah beneath which rivers flow." There they will be adorned with gold bangles. They will wear green garments made of fine silk and raw silk, and they will recline on couches. Jannah is a fine reward indeed, and the best of resting places. Surah Kahf, verse 31. Number 9. Cures from the Quran and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Licking the fingers after eating. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam always licked his fingers after eating. Muslim 5296 from Hazrat Ka'ab bin Malik radiyallahu anhu. Allama Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah writes that licking the fingers after meals is exceptionally effective for digestion. Number 10. Quranic advice. Allah says in the Quran, all of this already mentioned is certainly advice. So whoever wills should adopt a path of submission that takes him towards the pleasure of his Rabb. However, you cannot will anything without Allah's will. No person can be rightly guided without Allah's will. Allah decides who will be rightly guided and who will not be, because verily Allah is all-knowing, the wise. Surah Dahr, verses 29-30. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين الحمد